is in the building.
Hello.
You're right.
I'm very well, thank you. Are you?
Can I tell everybody what you've just done?
Yes.
You've just woken up.
I've just woken up into the world, yeah.
Genuinely, literally been fast asleep.
Yeah.
And, so you travelled here. Do you sleep in the car a lot when you're...
Yeah, I do. I mean, I just, like, naturally just, like, just drop off in about 2 seconds.
I take it you have a driver. You're not sleeping at the wheel?
Oh, yeah, no.
That's good. That would be scary.
It would, slightly.
And you must be very busy right now because you've got a single out, which we're playing on Hallam FM. You've got the album coming out.
Yeah, I know. It's busy. I've got a tour soon as well in like 2 weeks' time, and yeah, it's all kicking off.
All kicking off. And so, live, do you get funny when people talk about the X Factor?
No, go for it. I don't mind at all.
It's no, there's a little bit though.
No, it's part of my life.
Right, okay.
Yes, go for it.
I thought you might have gone a bit, because a little bit snobby and a little bit, X Factor's a little
bit. No, it's the platform, you know, it got me where I am now, so, you know, it's part of me.
Okay, I'm going to read you something, right, which is why I thought you'd gone a little bit snobby and turning your nose up, looking down your nose a bit, right?
Listen, okay.
Diana Vickers knows that over a year of studio sessions, she's made the album that no X Factor contestant should have ever produced, a record that smashes up that particular rulebook and starts all over again.
Oh, I like that.
Cool.
But I just think it goes to show that you can go on shows like The X Factor and you can come out with some really good stuff at the end of it. Hey, The X Factor is a really good platform, but it's what you do after to establish yourself as your own artist that counts.
Very true.
Yes.
And how are you feeling about Leona Lewis and Alexandra Burke and some of those people? Do you enjoy their music?
I mean, they've come out with some really good stuff, I think, you know. I mean, they've got number ones for it, so they're doing something right.
And you're not bothered about where your song gets? Is that true?
No, I'm not. I mean, I am, of course I am. I want to do really well. I'd be gutted if it was like charted at 37.
Yeah. Sorry, hang on. I can hear a phone ring. Is that your... That's mine. I can't believe that.
That is shameful.
So unprofessional. Shall I see who it is or not? It's going to be boring.
Yeah, go on.
It'll be dull. Oh, you get it. You get it for me. Go on.
Okay.
Say hello, it's Diana Vickers.
Hello, it's Diana Vickers. Ollie, yeah, he's here. Do you want me to put you on to him? Okay, great, bye.
Oh dear.
Pointless.
Hello?
Hello, Ollie, this is Kieran, mate.
Who is it? Kieran?
Yes.
I'm literally in an interview with Diana Vickers right now. Can I ring you back?
Yeah, no problem, mate, no problem at all.
Thanks, bye.
He loves it.
He's going to be texting all his mates. I've just rung Ollie.
Oh,
guess who he's with? Diana Vickers. We love the single. Once.
Oh, good.
Once is a single. And I first played it on my show because part of my show is the All Request Lunch.
Right.
It's lunchtime. People ring up and pick what song they want. And loads of people started to ask for your record.
Oh, great.
Which was brilliant. And that was why it was so good to get it on and playlist it and things. Tell me about the song, Once. Well, I know it's written by Egg White and Kathy Dennis.
Yeah, it's written by them. And, you know, it's sort of like 80s. Electro, synthy bass, poppy, with a bit of an edge, and it's, you know, it's all about love, and I'm only gonna let you kill me once, like, I'm only gonna let you hurt me once, mate, and then I'm done, then I'm out of here, sort of thing.
So you wouldn't give a second chance?
I don't, you never know, but I didn't write the song, did I?
No, you just sing it.
Maybe, I don't know. Sometimes I don't know.
Do you know, I find that quite interesting because I know that songwriting is genuinely really important to you.
Yeah.
And you're a songwriter as well.
I am.
And I know that you know, I've read and heard from people inside your record label that they were so excited that you write your own songs. Mm. But your first single release, you haven't written it.
I know I haven't written it because, you know, there's some really amazing things on the album, but we just thought that Once was the right one to kick it all off with. Mm-hmm. Like, it's really catchy and really in your face. So even though the second one's something that I've written, I just thought, you know, Once is a tune. And Kathy Dennis wrote it even, so...
Can't go wrong, okay? Kathy Dennis, if people listening aren't quite sure, she has some of the major pop radio hits you hear every day. She's written them, right?
Yeah.
Brilliant. I'm going to read you another quote from you, right? Or at least this is what your PR people are saying.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Some of the Saturday night summing ups of Diana Vickers on The X Factor, quirky individual, kooky, they only cemented how separate Miss Vickers appeared from the stage schoolish tits and teeth Mariah-esque girls that have become resonant voices of the annual British singing bun fight.
Oh, I love that.
Blimey.
That's genius. That's brutal, that one.
That was a bit brutal. I mean, I took that as like, that's almost taking the mick out of people who go on The X Factor.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's such a controversial show, isn't it? Like, you know, some people hate it, but yet they like to watch it and they don't agree with it. But it's just one of those controversial issues.
Issues.
It really is.
It's an issue.
It's an issue.
Okay, now The Single Once is out on the 3rd of May. Gotta
The Single Once is out on the 18th of April. The album's out 3rd of May.
Oh, is that right?
I know my stuff.
Fly me, sorry. Have I cut? To be fair, is that right then?
Yeah, 18th of April, singles out, 3rd of May, album.
Right, thank you for that.
Thank you for that.
I'm about to blame someone else, Lee, from your record label. But I won't. But no, I should have checked that out. Okay, and the album, tell us a bit about it, because I don't know anything about the album. I don't know if many people do. I mean, tell us about it. What's happening? What's it called?
It's called Songs from the Tainted Cherry Tree. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, I've written the majority of it. I've worked with various different writers and producers like Ellie Goulding, Let's Be Champion, Narina Paolo, Guy Sigsworth, you know, some really different producers and artists. And that's brought variety to it and made it, you know, a really sort of feel-good pop album. Some of it's like electro synth bass, quite 80s pop, but there's some ballads in there. I thought it was really important to sort of like mix it up a bit.
Gotta mix it up. Keep the variety alive.
Yeah, definitely.
And when would you listen to this album? Is it one to put on at night with the candles lit in your bedroom, or when you're going out, or in the car? I mean,
every occasion. Like, I think there's some tracks on there that is like a bath time, sort of bedtime candle thing, but there's some songs on there that like driving, like tune, like dancing. It's good. It's a good one.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Well, I can tell you're chuffed about the album. Well, you would be.
Yeah, I am.
You wrote most of the stuff on there. You've sung the stuff. So good luck with it.
Thank you very much.
Now, listen, we...
Oh, gosh.
Right, I'm going to hold up what this is now. This is a pair of Diana Vickers knickers.
I love them, granny knickers.
They're big and elasticated.
Wow.
Tell you what, you could fit...
The way I like them.
You could actually make about 20 pairs of thongs.
Oh, yes, you could.
We're doing Win the Music through the month of March, right? Mm-hmm. So people get the chance to win lots of musical stuff. And there are a couple of like funny ones in there as well. So we're not doing Diana Vickers' album. Is that a phone again? That's not mine. Whose is that?
Oh, here are these people with their phones.
The unprofessional
so
people you've
unprofessional.
Got. Tell you what. Anyone whose phone rings in the studio should be sacked. No, hang on.
Because that just happened to you.
Mine went earlier. Whoops. Okay. Anyway, so what we want you to do is sign these knickers. We're going to give them away on the air.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
So let's do it.
Big marker pen.
I am signing them.
How do you feel about this at home? If you're listening,
I'm very excited.
Very soon you'll be able to win Diana Vickers knickers. Okay. It's incredible, this thing. We're the only radio station big enough to bring you stars' underwear.
Oh, wow. These are big knickers.
We might throw in a copy of the album as well, actually.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, my D has gone very out of place.
There you go. You're signing it. Put it on the table if you want. You're signing it across her leg.
I've done it.
Hooray! Woo! Diana Vickers.
Beautiful.
Diana Vickers knickers. Thank you so much for that.
You're welcome.
So, I've got to speak to you about old Quegnog.
Quegnog?
Yeah,
Quegnog. Yeah,
Quegnoggy. Oh, what's he up to these days? Do you stay in touch, first of all?
I don't know what he's up to. I think he's back at school, I think. I don't know. But we just stay in contact.
You didn't stay in contact?
No, okay. Didn't.
Are you speaking to anybody?
Yeah, I see Ruth Lorenzo like practically every day of my life. And I saw JLS Boys the other day as well, so I see them every so often.
They're good lads, aren't they?
Yeah, JLS. They're good'uns.
They're good'uns. So you got your tour starting very soon.
Yeah.
It's sort of kind of 4 or 5... sort of dates, isn't it?
Seven dates. March, yeah. And then I've got more dates coming in May.
How are you feeling about that? Are you... nervous about it, excited, can't wait, or been there,
you
done
just
it already?
Summed it up. No, not been there, done it already. I am so excited. It's going to be like my own set, my music, you know, really intimate gigs with my fans and stuff. And I really can't wait. Just to sing there with my live band and things, it's going to be awesome.
It's going to be great. It
yeah,
is going to be great.
Fingers crossed.
What do you think, just for a moment, what's the worst thing that might happen at a live gig?
A live gig, yeah, that the sound goes, but I will not, because I have the best sound person ever.
Is it, you just pointed
Simon,
at
yeah.
Like, hello, Simon.
That would be the worst thing, or that I forgot my words, which I probably wouldn't, or that some like crazy man ran on stage and was like, ah.
Ah, just what yeah. I was like.
He just went, ah.
Ah, don't so. Make us, ah. Yeah, that would be bad,
that
actually.
That would be awful.
That would be bad. Well, listen, we absolutely love the single Once. Can't wait to hear more of the album. And are we going to get another single off the album?
Yeah, definitely.
Excellent. Cool, okay. Well, Once is a single. We can't wait to hear and see more of you as well. And you're in Sheffield on the 17th, Monday the 17th.
Of May. Yes, I'm here.
At Leadmill. I'm reading you this off one of your people's BlackBerry.
Yes.
It's at Leadmill. Brilliant.
Well, that filling Monday, you with knowledge.
The 17th of May. Because actually, on the first thing I got sent through, Sheffield wasn't on there. So I was
no,
a
I know, but I am back. I'm back for you guys.
We will see you 17th of May too. Diana Vickers, thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for that.